I'm here with Matt, who's got a Prank Kids deck profile.
Let's go.
Let's get into it.
Alright, so for the monsters, you play three of each Prank Kids monster.
Yeah, took around.
Oh, yeah.
Three Prank Kids monsters.
So three of each.
Yep.
So what they do is, every time you link or fusion with these monsters, pretty much you get a free summon to summon any of these,
yep,
except for the one they're named.
From hand or deck?
Hand or deck.
Oh, hand or deck.
Yeah, so this one, you burn your opponent for 500, be annoying, poke, yep, with that, and special summon a Prank Kids monster from the deck in hand. This one, you gain 1,000 life points, so you stall with that.
Yep.
Same thing as the first. This one, you banish a card from your hand and draw, special summon another Prank Kids.
Yep.
This one, you send one Prank Kids spell trap card, and you get special summon Prank Kids.
And these are good for when you're getting close to time as well. Like any life point lead is always good.
You get the life point advantage with the dropsies,
yeah,
so.
Yeah.
That's the worst way to win, though.
The worst person, yeah.
Next, you have your hand traps.
Yep.
Two Ash, one Ghost just to get rid of something,
yep,
and two Effect Feeler just for the sake of it,
okay,
just cause, you know, just cause it's hand traps.
Yep, okay.
Now we'll go on to spells. So in this deck you play pretty much like, I think you play 9 poly.
One poly?
9.
9?
So yeah, like, 3 instant fusion. Where are the other ones? I'll just do it in order. You play 2 of the pranks. So
yep,
this one, at the end of the turn, you get to send 3 Prank Kids cards from the graveyard back to the deck, draw 1. Banish 1 Prank Kids card from your hand, get a Prank Kids token, so that's good for if you're breaking.
Yep.
2 Prank Kids place. You get to search 1 Prank Kids monster from your deck when activated. If you link summon with a Prank Kids monster, they lose 500 attack points on all your monsters. Fusion, you gain 500 attack points. 1 fusion recycling plant because extra search. Of course, 3 polymerization,
yep,
standard explanation. 3 pandemonium. This is great because it's a quick spell and lets you fusion summon using your Prank Kids monsters from your hand field.
So, hand or field?
Yep, hand or field.
Okay.
And we got 2 Call by the Grave. Yep. You can play 3, but don't want to really draw into it.
Yep.
2 Pearl Desires because you always chuck the second one.
Yep.
1 set rotation, so.
Oh, okay, yeah, set rotation.
Yeah, that's why you play the cycling play.
Yep. Alright.
The 1 terraforming is just to search if you don't, you know, draw this or the place. 1-1 for 1 to, get the fansies. 2 plan. You can play 1, but it's good to play 2 just to side it out.
Yep.
Pretty much what this does is lets you link someone your opponent's turn. Also, if it's sent to the grave and you can banish it, so you send it with fansies, you can send any number of Prank Kids cards from the graveyard back in the deck, and your opponent's monsters lose 100 attack for each.
Okay.
Now we'll go on to extra deck. Very straightforward. 1 Battle Butler. Quick effect, you can clear your opponent's front row. That's great. So,
mm-hmm.
2 Rock and Ride.
Yep.
Pretty much, you can. This card can lose 1,000 attack directly. That kind of sucks. You can also tribute this card, get to any Prank Kids non-fusion cards from the grave, and special summon them to the field.
Okay.
This one does it on your opponent's turn. So same thing as that, sort of. Except this cannot be, I think, Prank Kids monsters cannot be activated against Prank Kids monsters.
Cool.
Now we're going to the Link monsters. We play 3 Bow Wow Bark. Any monster that points to this card, any Prank Kids, gets 1,000 attack. if you send it to the grave, quick effect, you get special 2 Prank Kids monsters from the grave.
Okay.
Oh no, you get them to your hand, sorry. 2 Dodo. When this is summoned, you can add 1 Prank Kids spell or trap card. If you send it to grave on your turn only, you get 2 Prank Kids cards from your grave. 1 Roar and Roaster. This is just funny to clear back row decks like Altergeist and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
You can play Boral Sword, but I don't have it, so you play Borolo instead.
Yeah, me too.
And I feel like this is better than whatever you want to put in it, Decode Talker. Yeah. Just because you feel bored on first turn, if you want to get over big beefy monsters, you play that.
Yeah, increase the attack and stuff.
The Destroyed Abyss Dweller, because
yes.
anything they use is great. It's funny.
That's good. And you even have some water monsters, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, and totally awesome.
And totally awesome, because you can just keep recycling the dropsies.
Mm. Oh, nice. Did you have a side deck you want to go through?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Alright, we'll start with one ghost spell, just in case if you're playing against mirror matches, or if you want to get rid of something that's you're playing.
Ghost Reaper.
Yeah, Ghost Reaper, sorry.
You're right.
Well, I say ghost spell.
Yeah, you're right.
Two Lancia.
Yes.
Gets Soulcrest. Dino Wrestler. Yes. Gets Altergeist.
Against everything.
Yeah, against everything, really. Yeah. But Altergeist mainly. Drolls.
Yep.
Just don't even know why.
Yeah.
You can play the Invoked Engine in this, but... Mm-hmm. And if you do, you play a Magical Meltdown, so no one can get, you know, over your big guys. No one can stop your summonings, just be annoying with it.
Cool.
Ultra Poly, just to see what situation fits. A spare recycling plant, if you're not drawing it into enough. Twin Twisters, just for back row decks like Mystic Mine. Unending, also back row.
Mm-hmm.
Then these two spicy cards, Dark Rebellion and Eradicator.
Ooh, okay.
So pretty much you can get this off with the Roxies, because it's level 4. You play this against pretty much whatever you hate against.
Yep.
So like you can say Sky Striker, cool spell, you win game.
Nice, alright. Thank you for that profile, Matt.
All good.